Thanks for tuning in, guys. So today is a heavy deadlift day where I'll be trying to hit a heavy single or triple. We'll kind of see how I'm feeling. And it is Saturday, almost 11 o'clock. So let's get it. Enjoy the video, guys. Warming up, drinking my pre-workout. I do not drink my pre-workout like 15 minutes before I start lifting because it hits me way too hard then. So I drink it while I'm warming up. Feeling all right, so we will see how this goes. Also, for some reason, our school decided to get a Texas power bar, which is pretty sweet. I'm pretty excited about this. Attempting to make smarter jumps today. So I'm going from 315 to 345, so 30 pound jump. And now I'll throw on my belt to do it. So failed at 375, which absolutely sucks. It takes like 3 hours to get that thing off the floor, so I gotta work on that. So now moving on to deficit deadlifts. And also my sacrum is so rotated, it's killing me. So I think that's part of the problem, but yeah, so we're gonna get these. Backing down the weight to 225, so it's less painful, and no belt so I can work on my bracing. Clip back and I seem super depressed, but I'm not. I'm just very frustrated. Just so slow off the floor, so it's very demotivating when I'm lifting it up. But, and also my sacrum, absolutely killing me. That's why if you are a power lifter or lift in general, you need to see a chiropractor. It'll save your life. I need to get adjusted badly, but stopping the deadlifts just because it's kind of painful. Going to try to front squat and see if I can do that pain-free, but just need to get adjusted. Simple fix. All right, let's get it. So I'm just gonna stick with 115 lighter weight for 12 reps, 3 sets of this. So not too painful, so let's get it. Finished off the front squats, which was very hard. 12 reps, it's no joke. So now I'm just gonna do some, I can't remember what these called, glute hams. And that's about it because I'm hurting. So I'll get this done, maybe a little bit of cardio, I don't know. Get out of here. Alright guys, finished out that workout, which was not the greatest workout, but it happens. I'm human and I have crap workouts probably 85% of the time. So yeah, it's all good. So I just need to go home, get some food in me, just relax a little bit because I'm tired for some reason. But might go to TJ's, my favorite place in the world. And I need more protein because I'm already almost out of that phase 8 white chocolate stuff. And bodybuilding.com usually does their BOGO sale on it. Buy one, get one free, which is such a good deal, and they're not doing it. So please do it. But yeah, I might go to somewhere and try to snag some protein. We'll see. I don't like paying a lot of money for protein, so yeah. But thank you guys for checking out the video and stay tuned for the rest of today's events. Check you later. Alright, before I forget, I got more muscle egg in the mail the other day. So, I got cake batter again, and it comes frozen. So, I have to let this thaw out for like a couple of days yet. So yeah, my friend bought it last time, 2 gallons. And this time I bought it and split it again, so yeah, love this stuff. Like a lot, it lasts me like over a month, I'd say, so I think it's a good deal. And egg whites are expensive right now, so recommend getting these. And they taste delicious, so get them. Guys, so for post-workout meal, I'm gonna have some thinly sliced pork chops from Trader Joe's and 2 servings of broccoli. I'm saving most of my macros for later when I get Chipotle, so that's the reason I'm doing this. And then this is just Greek yogurt and some peanut butter, and I'm gonna throw it on a couple of rice cakes, and that will be post-workout meal. White rice, please. No beans. Can I get extra fajitas though?
Extra what?
Fajita veggies.
Just corn, please. Then actually, I think this one is good. I'll do the side of chips and guac.
Yeah, that's good. And yeah, that's fine. Chicken.
I'm gonna do carnitas as well.
Mild and medium and lettuce, and that is it. Do something fruity.
Like, comment, and subscribe.